Hello, my beautiful people on YouTube, Facebook, here on my private group on Instagram as well. And same thing, one moment. Give me one moment, my loves. There you go. I think you can hear me fine. Technology. So anyway, welcome everybody. I'm so excited to be here this morning. I'm excited about the word that we're going to be learning. We're going to study how to become a happy woman, no matter what. And more than that, how to have joy, no matter the circumstances, no matter what we're going through. So for those of you who are new, we're studying the book, The Virtuous Woman of Today. And today we're studying chapter number 9, which is Be a Happy Woman. So without any further ado, let's get it started. Welcome once again, my loves, and I welcome everybody from YouTube, Instagram, from my private Facebook group that are connecting. Thank you so much for being here with me today, guys, and I want to dive in quickly on the word because we have a lot to learn today, so I'm excited about that. But before I do that, I encourage you guys to give it a like to this video, to share it with other ladies. Remember that that's the way that we can come together as sisters and help each other and help each other grow. So make sure you think of somebody you can share this video with and go ahead and do that. Also turn on notifications so you guys don't miss any of these live videos and all the things that God places on my heart to share with you guys. So if you guys have the notifications on, you will be able to receive them. So make sure you do that. Something like our daily devotionals that I'm doing from Monday through Friday. I hope you guys are taking advantage of these devotionals. The whole idea is to help you get the day started with the right food, being inspired, being motivated with the Word of God. And on Mondays, it's called Good Morning, Lord, and it's just a 5-minute devotional that will help you start your week right. And from Tuesday to Friday, it's called Wisdom Seeds. And that's what literally it is. It's seeds that's gonna help you get inspired for the day and continue growing and having a successful day and an inspired day with the Lord. Amen. So go ahead, listen to them. It's in a audio podcast format. So that being said, let's get started with prayer. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much, Lord, for this beautiful day that you have given us today. Thank you for the opportunity to be here in your presence, Father. And we ask you to please give us today the strategies to be happy women, the strategies to have joy no matter the circumstances, Father. I ask that you please give us those divine strategies, Lord, that we can apply in our day to day. In the name of Jesus, we pray, and everybody says amen. Thank you for everybody who is connecting once again. So we studied last week a powerful topic called Be a Woman of Vision, and we did it for the past 2 weeks. We created a vision writing, and that was chapter number 6 on the book. So we're going to be jumping to chapter number 9, which is Be a Happy Woman. But make sure, guys, you go and read the other two chapters, chapter 7 and chapter 8. They are very important, very motivating. Chapter number 7 is called Be a Confident Woman, and chapter number 8 is called Be a Patient Woman. So if you're like me and you're an impatient person, that chapter is going to really minister to your life. So go ahead, read those. But today we're going to focus on chapter number 9, which is how to be a happy, joyful woman. Amen. So if you guys are ready to get started, typing an amen. If you're watching, wherever you're watching, typing an amen. If you're listening to this later, you can still type in your amen. So I want us to grab the Bible and let's study Psalms 118:24. So let's read that because that is the baseline of what we're going to be studying today. Psalm 118:24. It says, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in him." What a beautiful scripture. It's one of my favorite ones because it reminds us, guys, that God has created this day for us. He has created this day so we can rejoice, so we can be happy, so we can have joy no matter the circumstances. And I have a question for you guys that I asked myself that question several times. How many times have we read the psalm, but we never allow it to really minister to our life. How many times we have really meditated on it and understand it and actually run with it. Like, understand that God has created this day so we can be happy, we can be joyful in it. So if you look around and see that you are not noticing God's blessings in your life, you're not enjoying every day, that you are stressed out over things, that means that you really don't understand what this verse means and you haven't applied it in your life. And I invite you to read the psalm with me right now, guys. I know you guys may not be able to stop what you're doing right now, but I encourage you to close your eyes for a moment if you can. Close your eyes for a moment and let's do this exercise together. I did this exercise and it really helped me understand that there are so many reasons to be joyful no matter what we're going through that I want to do this exercise with you. And it's meditating on this psalm. Really what it says is the Lord has created this day. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So let's close our eyes for a moment, and I'm going to mention certain things. And if that is you, if you feel Diana's speaking to me, this is me, that is an enough reason for you to have joy and happiness on this day. So first of all, with your eyes closed, if you have air in your lungs this morning, say an amen. Amen. If you have air in your lungs this morning, if you have food in your fridge today, if you have a roof over your head, if you are healthy, if you have family, if you can see, hear, feel, run, think, walk, if you have freedom, if you have, and this is the most important one, if you have a God who loves you, cares for you, protects you, and watches over you. If that is you, I want you to type in an amen. I want you to, in your heart, say thank you, Lord. And that means that you have enough reasons, my love, to be happy and joyful today. Because what God was ministering to me through these birds is everything that God has given us. Every single thing, even if it's one of them, is enough to be happy, is enough to be joyful. Now, one of the things, and I think we can agree, all of us that are right now listening to this, we can agree to two of them that we cannot deny we have. One of them, that we have air in our lungs. If you're listening to me, that means you're breathing. And two, that we have a God who loves us, cares for us, protects us, and watches over us. If you're here, that means that you have the same God that loves you. And that is reason enough to be joyful, to be happy, because we know that everything will work out for our good, that God is watching over us, that He's protecting us. And that is an enough reason, guys, to be joyful. It means that you have enough reasons, once again, to be joyful. Today is a new day and a new opportunity to be happy. Don't waste it. Don't waste it. Be joyful. Amen. Now, the Lord has created today especially for you. Do you know that? That the Lord and the Word of God says that He designs every day especially for you. It's an special day for you so that you can rejoice in Him and His creation. So for you to enjoy yourself and enjoy and rejoice everything He gives you in overabundance every day, so that you can count with His presence, His grace, His favor, so you don't have to worry about tomorrow and you can rest peacefully today and assure that God is in control of your life. So God creates every day and designs every day like that for you, so you can really, truly enjoy it. And we waste our time, we waste our life, guys, being worried about tomorrow, being worried about something that we don't even know if it's going to happen or not. But if we believe that God is guiding our steps, that He's protecting us, that He cares for us, then we're going to be able to realize that the Lord has already everything done for us. And we don't have to worry about anything. We don't have to worry about our future because God is in control of everything. Amen. Now, it is necessary to learn to enjoy each day as if it was our last day. Can you imagine, guys, if today was your last day? If just picture it. Would you waste it being worried? Would you waste it being anxious? We most likely we will enjoy it to the fullest. So that's what God wants us to do. He wants us to enjoy every day to the fullest. Jesus died on the cross for you and for me so that we could live a fulfilled and joyful life. And most importantly, a life with God's presence. And that's why we need to enjoy it. That's why we need to embrace it and be happy with it. Amen? Now, there is a difference, and this is something I want to explain to you today, guys. There is a big difference between joy and between happiness. And when you are joyful, that joy can only come from God. That's something that only God can provide, that type of joy. And when we're talking about happiness, is more momentary, is more emotional. It's something that the world offers to you. So if you get it, if things are going your way, if you're getting the promotion, or if you're doing those things that you were aiming for and you were expecting and you receive them, you feel happy. And it's momentary, it goes away. But joy is something that it gets deeper in your heart and that only God can provide. And that joy stays with you no matter the circumstances. That joy stays with you no matter how you're feeling, no matter how things are going, if they're going your way or not, it remains with you. So I want us to go and study and read right now Colossians 2:7. So let's look it up in the Bible, Colossians 2:7, and let's read it because it teaches us how we can have that kind of joy. It says, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness. And this is the key word right here. With thankfulness. How can we be joyful? How can we have joy all the time? Being grateful, being thankful to God for the things that we have and the things that we don't have. To live a life full of joy, it is necessary to live and apply the Word of God more intentionally in your life and to know Him more intimately. When you really know God, when you read the Word of God and you're seeking Him because you want to know Him, not so much for what He can do for you, but because you want to know Him, you get to know His character. And God's character will prove to you that He can do it all. He's the God of the impossible. He's the God who created everything so you can have joy. And that alone will give you joy. When you start applying God's Word in your life, you will feel fulfilled. Everything will start working out for your good, and you will experience joy. Now, through all that, we need to be grateful, right? This is the only way to experience the peace, joy, and happiness you're looking for. And I'm speaking by experience, guys. When I was writing this book, and if you read that chapter, you guys are gonna find out that through the testimony, I was trying to find happiness and joy in different ways here on earth, and I couldn't find it. I realized that God is the one and the only one who can give us that kind of joy that we are looking and that kind of peace that surpasses all understanding. He's the only one who can give it to us. Now, the Word of God is a source of living water and is vital for you. Is vital for you. I'm sorry. So the more you consume the Word of God, the more you're gonna feel alive. And I was telling my ladies in the Spanish group that I have a little plant right now that is struggling a little bit, and I couldn't understand why she was struggling. It felt like she was dying. And I realized, but because we have the heat on in the house, is drying out the plant even more and faster, and it's struggling, it's suffering, it needs more water. And just comparing this and seeing this with my own eyes, right? The plant suffering and struggling and dying made me realize that we are the same way. When we're not feeding ourselves with the Word of God, we start dying inside. Our joy starts going away and we start suffering, guys. So that's why the Word of God, and this, the Word of God says that in His Word, is that the Word of God is living water for us, and it's fundamental for our life. Now, the closer, and if you guys notice that, the closer a tree is to a water, and whether it's a fountain or a river or whatever it is, the bigger it is, the more fruits it gives. Why? Because it's being fed, and the roots get deeper on the earth because it's being fed with good water, right? And in the same way is the Word of God for us. It's exactly the same way. When the storm arrives, it will not knock us off, because we will have, and we will be able to resist, just like those trees, because we have been feeding ourselves with that beautiful fountain of water that comes from the Word of God. Amen. So we will have everything that we need. We will have the right God's promises, the right things that God says about us, and we will be able to confront whatever it comes. But most importantly, we will have that joy deep in our hearts. Now, our joy should not depend on our circumstances here on earth, but the promises that God has for us on heaven. And that's why it is important, once again, the more we read the Word of God, the more we're being fed the right things in our mind, in our hearts, and the more it's preparing us for those kind of moments. I want us to read Colossians 3, 1, 2. So let's go to the Bible. Let's read what the Word says here, because it's really going to teach us that importance to stay focused on the Word of God. Colossians 3, 1, 2 says, "Since then you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things." So what is God telling us here? Stay focused. Put your focus on things above, on things that are bigger and higher than your day to day. And when we put our focus on God, on what God says about any circumstances, we are going to be able to find joy in the midst of that. But if you put your focus on earth, on the things that are happening in front of you, then you're going to lose your joy, because you're going to realize that you are a limited person, that there is certain things that you can do, but beyond that, you won't be able to do more. But God is the God of the impossible, and He will be able to do above and beyond what you were expecting. And that alone gives you joy and peace to wade through the circumstances. Amen. Now, when we focus on heavenly things, the earthly things become lighter and less important. The more you put your focus on God, the less you're going to realize that things here on earth are not that important, or what you think about yourself is not that important, because what is important is what your Creator thinks about yourself. Now, some examples on how to focus on heavenly things instead of earthly things are, I'm going to give you a couple of them. So I'm taking them from the book, and I want us to really meditate on that, guys, because when we are able to put our focus on heavenly things, on what God says about every circumstances, we are able to be joyful and peaceful no matter what we're going through. So here are some examples. Instead of comparing ourselves to other people, we should thank God for who we are and the unique abilities He has given us. So instead of putting our focus and comparing ourselves to the abilities that other people have, or the amount of money other people have versus us, or the talents they have versus us, and instead of that, we focus and we put our focus on what God says about us as an individual, the abilities that He has given us, the blessings that He has given us, we are able to put our focus there instead of here, and immediately we're going to have more joy in our life. Amen. Another one is, instead of complaining about what we don't have, we should thank God for what we do have and His promises to give us a better future. So instead of putting our focus on, these are the things that I don't have, and I'm frustrated and I'm unhappy because things are not going my way, or I'm not getting things fast enough, instead of focusing on that, if we focus on God's promises, what He says, knowing and understanding that His plans are better than ours, that He has an amazing future in store for us, if we put our focus on that, we're going to have more joy immediately, because our focus is in the right place. Amen. Now, instead of focusing on all the doors that has been closed, we should thank God because He is the one who opens and closes doors depending on our need. So instead of focusing on, you know, I applied for this job and I didn't get it, or I was trying to do X and Y and I couldn't get it, we focus on, thank you, Lord. Thank you because you closed those doors because you have something better in store for me. And I have many testimonies of that at the moment it seemed like a bad thing, like a door closed, and it seemed like a bad thing, but God turned it on to be an amazing thing. I got something better, a better offer, or whatever it was. So we have to trust, and when we put our focus on the right thing, we're able to have joy the moment that door closed because we're trusting God. Amen. And finally, instead of wasting time looking for happiness in the world, we should focus on finding joy in the Word of God. So when we actually start realizing and understanding that happiness is momentary, that happiness is something that will go and come depending on what the world offers us, and we understand that joy is something that is permanent, is something that God puts it in our heart very deep and nothing and nobody can touch it, then we're going to be able to have the focus on the right place and be able to enjoy everything no matter what. Amen. Now, when you make the decision to focus and pay attention, you make a decision. This is a decision that you make, guys. This is not something that God will force you, or I will force you, or life will force you. It's you. You yourself have to make that decision. Do you want to be a joyful woman? If the answer is yes, then you make the decision to focus on heavenly things. Then you say, Lord, I'm going to start going forward seeing life the way you want me to see it, because God knows better, guys. And when you see things the way God, through God's glasses, then you will be able to enjoy life way more and enjoy everything as it comes, no matter what. Amen. Now, today, the whole point, guys, is to teach you some practical steps that can help you have that joy, that can help you have the happiness, even if it's momentary, that it turns into becoming a joyful moment in your life. And these steps are going to help you with that, as they help me and continue helping me through my journey of becoming that virtuous woman. Amen. Now, step number one is to stop living in emotions and live in the joy of the Lord. So that's the first step. Stop living in emotions and live in the joy of the Lord. What does that mean? We're not gonna go by, once again, I'm happy because I was able to get in my way, or I'm happy because it happened exactly how I wanted it to happen, or at the time that I wanted to happen, in the place that I wanted to happen. But instead of that, we're gonna rely on God. And don't let anything steal your joy and peace, because things are not going your way. That doesn't mean they're not going to go the good way, the correct way, the way God has intended it to go. So I want us to read James 1, 2, 3. This is going to really help us understand this a little bit deeper, guys. So let's go to James 1, 2, 3. It says, consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of any kind, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. And just reading this, guys, how many of you say amen this morning? Just hearing this gives me so much joy, more joy and peace, because it helps me understand that no matter what trial I'm going through, no matter what process I'm going through, everything will work out for good. If God is allowing us to go through something, it's because He's building a character in us. He's helping us maybe understand that what He has in store is better than what we're going through right now. And all of that gives me a sense of peace and joy and trust through any circumstance and any process that I'm going through, because I'm really understanding that I'm not gonna live by emotions, by what I'm seeing at the moment or what I'm feeling at the moment, but instead, I'm gonna live by the joy of the Lord. I'm gonna live by His promises and what he's saying about every single circumstances, and understanding that, once again, if I'm going through it, he is building a character in me. He's making me resilient. He's making me being able to persevere for things. Amen. Now, James reminds us here of the importance of not losing our joy when we find ourselves going through hard trials. So remember, guys, that is important to treasure that joy that God gives us. Amen. Now, step number two, have a balance in your life. And I have to tell you with this, guys, that when I was struggling during that time of finding joy and happiness in life, and I was feeling impatient and irritated with everything, and I just wanted to quit everything, God, through these steps, made me realize that if we don't have balance in our life, we're gonna end up losing our joy. And the reason why is because God created us, right, to be able to enjoy every single area of our life, our social life, our health, our finances, but everything needs to be in balance. And I'm going to give you, and in the book, I give you some examples too, but today I'm going to very quickly give you some of those examples so you can evaluate yourself. We can evaluate each other and see where we're lacking right now, because if we're lacking joy or happiness at this moment, is because some of this can be out of balance. Amen. So here I am. I'm going to read it to you. You don't have to write or type in on the comments. Just meditate on it and say, yep, that's me. Yep, that's me. And then adjust. Amen. Bring the balance into balance. So it says, you spend more time at work than with your family. That can be a cause of stealing your joy. You spend more time watching television than doing productive things, advancing on your vision, advancing on the things that God is calling you to do. So this could be also stealing your joy. You spend more time complaining about your problems than spending time with God and learning about his promises for your life. So if you are complaining more, no wonder. And if you are lacking what God promises has for you, no wonder you're feeling the way you're feeling. You spend more time sitting than being active. Remember that God created us to be active creatures, and we need to be active. So sometimes when I feel like down or something, I just get up and go for a walk, and that immediately brings joy in my life because we were created to be active. You spend more time eating high fat foods than nutritious foods. Remember that your body, and we learn in a couple of chapters before too, that our body was built to be fed nutritious foods, and that's what's going to give you the energy, the fuel to get the things done. You spend more time worrying about tomorrow than enjoying the day today, and that is me. That right there is me right now. Sometimes I worry too much about tomorrow, about what I need to do, what I need to get done, or things like that, and I end up missing out on the beautiful day that God has given me and enjoying today. Amen. Now, you spend more time spending money than saving it. And it's important to have a good balance, right? To save for those days that we need or unexpected things happen, we can rely on it, and that can steal our joy. You spend more time listening than applying. And in this more specifically, I'm talking about the Word of God. It's very good to listen. It encourages. But if we don't apply it, remember that joy comes from applying the Word of God as well. You spend more time on chores than enjoying life. And that's me as well. Sometimes I feel myself doing, and not enjoying life. Amen. Now, if you identify with either of one of these examples, it means that the enemy is taking control of one of those areas of your life and is stealing your joy. That's why, my loves, it's so important to evaluate, to stop for a moment, to think about what I'm doing right, what I'm doing wrong, where am I in this balance in my life, and bring it back to balance. Amen. Now, step number three, use your talents. And this one, guys, it ministered so much to my life when God revealed it to me. One of the greatest pleasures in life is to dedicate the gifts and talents the Lord has given you to serve others. It is very important to give out of the abundance of talents and gifts that God has given you, to give it to other people, to serve other people. There is more pleasure in giving than in receiving. And when you do, you find great satisfaction and purpose for your life. God created us to help each other. God created us to serve each other. And the more you serve other people, the more you share your talents and gifts with other people, the more happy and joyful you feel. Now, you can use those talents by volunteering at church in any capacity you can, or also you can volunteer at Diana Bryant Ministries. We love helping and serving women all over the world. If you have a talent, a gift that you want to offer to the Lord, you can do it through this ministry as well. So DM me if that is you, if you're interested, on volunteer in any capacity, and you will see how much joy that is going to bring, sharing your talents with other people. Amen. Now, and this is the last step, step four, is practice gratitude every day. It is fundamental, guys, to practice gratitude. And that's something I learned to do, and I implemented it years ago, and I do it every single day. Gratitude is a powerful weapon to combat the enemy and his lies. Every single time the enemy tries to make me see something or put my focus on earthly things, on chasing happiness, gratefulness helped me put the focus once again on the Lord, on what he says, and the wonderful things that he has given me. When you thank the Lord for what you have and what you have not received yet, you are showing the enemy that he has no control over your life and he cannot steal your joy. Amen. So that's why it's important to thank God for the things that you can see, and also for the things that you cannot see, and you're waiting and expecting God to give it to you. Amen. Now, I want to read how I close this chapter in the book. I want to read it word by word. It says, Jesus died on the cross, not only for your sins, but also for you to enjoy life and to have a close and intimate relationship with God. Enjoy these privileges and enjoy the day that the Lord has prepared for you, virtuous woman. So don't forget to enjoy this day. Don't forget to every single day remember that God has created everything for you. Listen to the birds, look at the nature, look at the snow if you live in a place like mine where it snows, look at the flowers, look at everything that God has given you. He has created it for you, and that's going to bring so much joy, pleasure in your life, and it will really encourage you to focus on the heavenly things and not on the earthly things. Amen. So I'm so excited about this 9th puzzle piece that we have learned, and I'm really hoping, guys, that you guys are enjoying these lessons, that you guys are activating yourself in every single thing that we have learned. Remember that all the classes are always recorded. They are on my YouTube channel, so you can go and find them there, and I encourage you to invite more people to listen to this, to like, to share, so we can continue growing and serving other people, other women, to become that virtuous woman that God has called them to be. I will be here next Wednesday, same time, same channels, wherever you're watching me, I will be here at noon. But remember that tomorrow we have a workshop with Angelica. So if you want to activate these steps that we talked today, join the workshop. Saturday, we have the devotional with my sister Jessica on our private Facebook group, Transform Your Life. We're going deeper in the Word of God. Tuesdays in that same group, we're having prayer where we pray for your petitions with Mio Sotis. And every single day, remember, guys, Monday through Friday, I have a devotional out there, a podcast devotional of 5 minutes or 1 minute where you can get your day started in the right way, being inspired with the Word of God and growing and planting good seeds in your mind. Amen. That being all, let's close in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this beautiful day. Thank you for the word you have planted in our hearts today, Father. Thank you for helping us and reminding us, Lord, that you are the one who gives us joy, Father, that we can find that joy in you, that joy that kept us enjoying every single aspect of our life, no matter the circumstances, Father. We ask you to please help us remember every day to put our focus in you, on the heavenly things, Father, and that you direct every single step of ours, and you help us every day to become the virtuous woman that you call us to become. Father, I pray for every single person, every single lady that is listening to this message today, that you give them the encouragement, the joy they need, Father, that you bless everything they do, Lord, and that you always, always, your presence is always with us, Lord. Thank you, Father, and in the name of Jesus we pray, and everybody says, amen, amen. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me today. It was a pleasure being here with you every Wednesday. I really enjoy being here, reading your comments. I really, really enjoy it. So thank you for being here. I'll see you next Wednesday. I love you guys. Have a blessed day.